And now, a soothing bedtime lullaby. It's Mike Malloy.
Twenty-five before the hour. This hour is being sponsored by John Malkins. He is with peoplescongress.org. You should visit that website, peoplescongress.org. His message for Mike and all he's done to keep America on its toes, join the conversation to transform America's government at peoplescongress.org. Check it out, please. Regarding the logic of the right-wingers, Michael and Roswell writes, logic has nothing to do with it. It's about the emotional impact of the message. For instance, James Dobson of Focus on the Family has just in the last day or so said that Planned Parenthood distributes defective condoms in order to make more money from their abortion business. Jesus God, is there anything that right-wingers won't lie about? Mr. Dobson, your God is going to punish you severely after you die because your own holy text tells you not to lie. But I digress. James Dobson, a Focus on the Family, said that Planned Parenthood distributes defective condoms in order to make more money from their abortion business. And as Michael writes, think the wing nuts will mull over either the truth or logic of that statement? Hell no. They'll be getting condoms and putting pinholes in them to prove that Dobson's not lying his ass off. Logic? It was, if I recall correctly, the Tennessee legislature that wanted Tennessee public school math textbooks to reflect their sincerely held belief that the mathematical designation pi should be rounded down to 3. Logic got nothing to do with it. Mike. Michael. Gonna round pi down to 3. Yeah, well, why not? It'd be a lot simpler, wouldn't it? You half-witted jerks. This is so right-wing. I mean, it is so right-wing. Orrin Hatch. Orrin Hatch. Who at one time, as a senator from Utah, he's being challenged, I think, in a primary this year. He could be counted on to be a center-right Republican. A career Mormon legislator, no question. Old Orrin just liked being there in the Senate so he could posture and have his nails and hair done and just look so good and so, you know, Utahian. Well, but he stayed out of the muck. Orrin used to stay out of the muck. Oh, he was a devious senator from Utah, but he stayed out of the muck. No longer. He said the other day in an interview with, I don't know, some right-wing Jesus, I don't know, interview. He warned supporters that Democrats are going to attack Mitt Romney's Mormon faith during the presidential campaign. Yes. Now, how does Orrin know that? He knows. Beck told him, or some of these right-wing bloggers or talk show hosts or radio geeks or whatever. They told him, so it must be true. Now, this is the part that is stunning. The right wing has done nothing but attack Obama's religious status since before he was elected. It's been unending. They attack everything about his professed position about his religion. Obama, I think, is from the old school. You know, you don't drag out your religion and parade it in front of folks as if to say, aha, I'm better than you. No, that's what evangelical Christians do. Oh, come on, spare me the emails. That's exactly what they do. But Obama's old school. You go to church? That's nobody's damn business. You want to go to church? Go to church. If you don't, you don't. Look at Reagan. Reagan, in his 8 years as president, never set foot in the church, unless it was somebody's funeral. But the mere idea that Obama would attack Mitt Romney because of his religious belief is so over the top, so insane, so slobberingly typical of the Republican base. And the only reason Orrin's doing it is because he knows, you know, he's got this reputation of being a dinosaur. He's been in the Senate for so long, you know, smooth, slick-talking Orrin, right? And he's afraid he's going to lose his position of power. So he's getting in the muck, too. He doesn't care. Oh, they're going to attack my good friend Mitt Romney because he's a Mormon. Isn't Harry Reid a Mormon? Yeah, I think he is. They're everywhere. They're everywhere. But the mere fact that Hatch would say that. And as Debbie Wasserman Schultz, the chairwoman of the Democratic National Committee, said, she described what Orrin Hatch said as preposterous, utter nonsense. And she pointed out that the Democrats would not stoop to the same levels. It's not stooping, Ms. Wasserman Schultz. It's rolling. It's just getting down in the slime and rolling around in it. That's what Republicans do. And the Democrats wouldn't go to the same level as Republicans. Wasserman Schultz said, quote, let's remember that President Obama has had so many things hurled at him. Birth certificate questions, whether or not he's a Christian. And for them to suggest that religion will be injected by Obama and the Democratic Party, I mean, I think they need to take a look inward at the accusations that their party and their supporters have hurled before they take that step, end quote. And then in Utah last night, Hatch repeated it. He said, quote, for them to say they aren't going to smear Mitt Romney is baloney. It's way out of bounds, but that's what is going to happen, end quote. This from a guy who has watched his own party, as sludgy and putrid as it's become, do everything imaginable to attack Obama. His race, his parents, his wife, his children, his religion, his college education, everything. Not once in almost 4 years have they ever challenged with an idea of their own his positions on government. Never, not once. Hey, Boner, where are the jobs? Hey, Boner, where's all that stuff you and Cantor were going to do? Craig Janis, who's a Mormon, and is working for the Utah Democratic Party to recruit Latter-day Saints church members, said, quote, divisive and unsubstantiated claims about religion have no place in our debate. This is a country that was founded on the principles of respect and freedom for religion, right? See what happens when you grant freedom and respect to something that is ultimately destructive? I said that, not Janis. Mr. Janis goes on, we hope that going forward, Senator Hatch will remember that as a statesman, what? He is held to a higher standard of conduct and will choose his words more carefully. Well, Craig Janis, who is also a Mormon and you know, trying to sign up other Mormons to go Democrat, which they won't, you know, in the first place, they only granted people of color official status in their religion, what, within the last 20 years, 25, 30 years? I mean, come on. Come on. But what was interesting to me about the story is the fact that Orrin Hatch, like every single one of these right-wing destroyers, phonies, hypocrites, lovers of injustice, is so willing to to get right down in the slime and the garbage. And it's you know, several feet deep. And it's been created. It's washing this country coast to coast, border to border, across the once fruited plain. Now it's a sludge plain. And the right wingers have created it, just dumped all the lies and hatred and deceit and terror and fear of their own shadows. I have never seen such a bunch of cowards as this current crop of right wingers. And I don't care where they are. Every single one of them, even the ones who try to describe themselves and, you know, well, I'm not Republican, I'm a libertarian.